The Biden administration is expected as soon as this week to recommend that most Americans get a COVID-19 booster shot after their second dose. The move would be an about-face from the federal government's earlier recommendation that only the severely immunocompromised need boosters. Federal agencies said as recently as August 12 that boosters weren't needed for most Americans, but the administration has been signaling the possible shift for more than a week. Dr. Anthony Fauci, director of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, told USA Today's editorial board August 6 that the vaccine's durability wanes with time and boosters might eventually be necessary. "We all feel that sooner or later, likely the elderly before the young, it makes sense. That's just the way the immune system is," he said. Last week, the Food and Drug Administration authorized a third booster dose of the Pfizer vaccine for people who are severely immunocompromised, because they often are not able to produce protective antibodies against COVID-19. But the science has been rapidly evolving, especially as the hyper-contagious Delta variant spreads. The move was not an application but, according to Pfizer, was intended to support evaluation of a possible booster dose. "Because it is furthest along, adding a third shot to the Pfizer-BioNTech's vaccination schedule likely would be adopted first, followed by Moderna. It's not clear if or when a recommendation for a second shot of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine would be made. Long-term data on the company's vaccine, which makes up only 5% of doses administered in the United States, is still being gathered. Because the J&J vaccine was authorized on February 27, even the first recipients received it only 5 months ago. Reports on the website of Israel Ministry of Health show protection from the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine dropped precipitously after 6 months, down to 40% to 50% effectiveness against infection, said Dr. Eric Topol, vice president for research at Scripps Research in La Jolla, California, and a national expert on the use of data in medical research. "It gets down to the 40% to 50% effectiveness range, whereas it used to be 95%, Topol said. "That would mean that many healthcare workers and nursing home residents, who were the first to be vaccinated in the United States, could be nearing a fall-off in protection." Topol emphasized that the vaccines in use in the United States still strongly protect against serious illness and death. "That's the question that concerns Dr. Gregory Poland, director of the Mayo Clinic's Vaccine Research Group. It's not certain that waning antibody levels necessarily mean that everyone who got either the Pfizer-BioNTech or Moderna vaccines will be at risk for breakthrough infections over time. Companies are adopting COVID vaccine mandates for employees. So why aren't all vaccine makers? To answer that, real-world effectiveness data that hasn't yet been published is needed," he said.